Yeah, but do you think
listen,
you,
like... I love you and all, but shut the fuck up.
Fuck childhood sweethearts.
Over there.
What?
Why are you putting it over there?
I can't read that. Is that a seven? What is that?
Forced proximity I hate because it usually means arranged marriage.
Was thinking like spies or whatever?
Why did you go to arranged marriage?
What the hell's wrong with you? I don't know. I feel like I see arranged marriage all the time. I hate second chances.
Oh my
god.
I think you hate second chances because it relates to childhood.
Oh, this is a therapy session.
Oh, I love fake dating.
I hate fake dating because all dating is fake.
No, your stupid friends are too stupid to know that you're fake dating a famous football player or something.
No, this isn't fun.
Could we talk about it?
They never have to talk about their feelings because they're fake dating.
Okay, I get why you're doing it. That's back to forced proximity.
You can't put that in four?
No, no, it's fine. You know what? No, you do it. It's fine. I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Okay,
I'm breaking out in hives.
Wait, we forgot about possible sibs/hot steps. That can't be our third.
Number three?
That's in the top three, baby.
I was going to say two.
Possible step siblings is crazy.
I've been
you're out of your fucking mind.
Same dude for like 30 years. It's
and you want him to be your step sibling?
Why did you have to ruin it? Why did you have to say that? Fine, it's a three. You went and ruined it. It's a three.
Now, am I captain of the debate team? Stop.
You're really not.
I am the brains of this operation.
I don't know what to say. You're turning us into a grumpy sunshine.
Okay.
All right,
hello, slay.
Book Lovers was really the first time I saw that.
Book Lovers was the first time that I
did the plot.
And now with my
highly evolved brain.
Enemies to Lovers is number one, I think. Grumpy Sunshine is two. What do you think?
I'll go with that, actually.
I
don't know.
I can't publicly stand by this list.
What? It's oh fine. God. Enemies I'm to sweating. Lovers. I'm possible sibs, hot steps, still think
that can't be three.
Dating, second chances.
No! Any parting words to this absolute monstrosity that we've created?
Yeah, you got some problems.
Cheers!
Oh God, what if when he sees me, I like him and he knows it? What if he opens up a door and I can't close it? What happens then?
Ooh, piece of candy. Ooh, another piece of candy. Another piece of candy. Ooh, more candy. Ooh, more candy. Wait a minute. Are you trying to get me to go outside again? Dang it.
You shout like that, they put you in jail. Right away. No trial, no nothing. Journalists, we have a special jail for journalists. You're stealing, right to jail. You're playing music too loud, right to jail. Right away. You're driving too fast, jail. Slow, jail. You're charging too high prices for sweaters, glasses. You write to jail. You undercook fish, believe it or not, jail. You overcook chicken, also jail. Undercook, overcook. You make an appointment with the dentist and you don't show up, believe it or not, jail, right away.
Well, this was fun. I'm gonna go to bed for a few days.
I learned nothing. It was, you know, vanilla. Also, I am a big sucker for, like rescuing. I'm just trying to figure out where my parenting went off the rails, but you're like, my kink is being rescued.
Are you quit?
No, it's actually exactly. I love when it's like they're in the middle of a fight, like things have gone horribly wrong, and they fucking hate each other, and then she gets kidnapped, so he has to go to go get her, so they can finish their fight. Is why he's going to get her.
Okay, so I have one stereotype that or trope that really bugs me, and that is, can we please, in the age of the internet with so much information out there, can we eliminate the trope of the virginal girl who looks up with her doe eyes?
How did he do?
Yeah,
just, was it good?
Something wrong? No, you put it in your mouth.
But it's like when she's not sure if he's gonna show up because they've had a fight so bad.
He's pretending to be like a normal dude. So
they all.
So rude.
So she's all like, oh my god, I'm tied up. And he's all like, I'm gonna get you. And then they have crazy sex afterwards.
That thing where they're always like, I will always come for you. Like,
yes, but yes, yes.
See, okay, but see, I've been in the same relationship for like, what, 34 years, something like that? Mm-hmm. I'm not counting. Anyway, so my kink is more, he screws up, and I won't be, it's okay. He screws up and like has to apologize. Yeah, but yeah, I don't need to be tied up for that, but.
Well, must be nice.
Hi.
Hi. What you doing?
Reading.
Books are literally so funny. They do not even need to try. I mean, if you are reading a book with any amount of romance in it, buckle in because you about to be chuckling. Like, listen to this line. This is the whole sentence, okay? When he shifted to lean into his chair, his coat strained against his muscles. Tell me you did not harumph. It's too good. It is too good.
This is why you don't have an arch nemesis, Terry, because you focus on the wrong details.
Maybe I don't have an arch nemesis because I solve all my crimes.
That's a pretty f***ed up thing to say to me.
The problem with sports romances is as soon as it gets good, I'm like, should I make this my whole personality? I don't give a fuck about sports, okay? Never have, never will. And then Nate says absolutely one cute thing, and I'm suddenly like, should I become an international Olympic figure skater? Be honest. No, I'm literally 5'1" with a soft tummy and big titties, okay? It's not in the cards for me. And that's fine. I've never wanted it to be. But this is the problem with these stupid books. I'm just minding my business, reading a cute book, and then Nate says, I can't believe you think I could ever reject you, Anastasia. You have no idea, do you? The lengths I'd go to if you'd let me. What I'd do to make you happy. And then I'm like, no, we've been through this before. Keep it together. Like, it's fine. Don't like sports, it's just a good romance. You don't like sports, it's... And then the main character says, I don't need defending. And he says, I know you don't, but you're worth defending. Every cut, bruise, every single pang of anger, frustration, it's all worth it. I threw my last punch defending you because you deserve to have someone be that person for you. And there's no one more qualified than me. And then I'm like, well, time to get the skates.
Next time you're at the bookstore or the library, stop telling yourself that you don't need more books. Stop being selfish for once and consider that maybe the books need you.
Women, for some reason, love sex books and murder.
I'll do one better. Give me a sex book that has murder in it, especially murder done by a morally gray character in the name of vengeance for their love. Chef's kiss.
When I said that, he smirked. The devil smirk. He growled in frustration. He pulled his bottom lip between his teeth and winked. I fell in love right there. I was sideways and he was lying face down on the bed. It was amazing. He said, not God, it's me. He snapped his teeth shut and started whistling, cheering me on for my performance. I started giggling maniacally.
I hear something purring. Wait, that's my pussy.
That's my pussy!
You need to listen to what I just did. So I just discovered that Word will read my book to me.
One. Paradigm. Thick, hot liquid runs down my arm. Blood. Funny, I don't remember the guard nicking me with his sword before my fist connected with his face.
You can change the voice. Hold on. So that was Alex. Let's hear Fred.
See, my right foot is gone. The smell of soot stings my nose and I clamped my right...
Okay, here's Samantha.
Then my right hook to his jaw.
Oh. Okay. The smell pretty is basic. Here's Victoria.
And I clamped my grimy hand over it to stop it from slipping out.
This is so entertaining.
This is why you can't take spicy booktok people to haunted houses. Because now, thanks to the books that we read, we are turned on by those characters that we're supposed to be afraid of. Hey, what's up? What you doing later?
Oh no. She stalled out.
Oh, don't lose the spot. Oh god. Oh, there's the book. Okay. Okay, well, you know what? I guess we'll just stay here.
Hey, coffee.
Can't be the only one to say that spicy books got me fucked up. Because my rational brain says you obviously don't want to be kidnapped and sold to a mafia leader. You don't need nor want a stalker. But then there's this tiny voice in the wee back of my brain that says, come on, just live on the edge a little.
I'll blow up into smithereens and spew my tiny symphony all up and down a city street while trying to put my mind at ease, like finishing this melody. This feels like a necessity, so this could be the death of me, or maybe just a better me. Now come in with the timpanis and take a shot of Hennessy. I know I'm not there mentally, but you could be the remedy, so let me play my violin for you.
So what do you do for fun? I really love to read. What kind of books are you into?
Okay, be cool. You knew this was coming. You don't need to tell them that you read 10 reverse harems in 7 days, or that dark romances with possessive alpha males that have knife kinks kind of sort of pique your interest. You definitely don't need to talk about the fact that the last fairy book you read had a fae who could change the size of his frickin' schlongosaurus at leisure, or that you're on the pro-joining side of a threesome feud between fans of a vampire series. Just say
fantasy.
I'm the chosen one, there's no time for fun. Did I mention I'm also an orphan? So my life is tough, to come to grips with this utopian dystopian apocalypse. And that's how it all unfurls, when you're not like the other girls. Not hot, okay? No need for confusion, as the author describing my face and my body might make you draw that conclusion. I'm caught between lovers on numerous occasions, but how can I choose from these mediocre Caucasians?
Oh, sorry. This cover is a lot more literal than you would first think. They actually put tape on her mouth so she was a silent patient. And she also had, I don't want to spoil this for anyone, she had an allergic reaction to the tape. As someone with seasonal allergies, it just really... I don't know, read the trigger warning. Like, this one was basically... it was a hard read for me. It was from the perspective of the apple that fell far from the tree and he had to get home. Really good read. Robin Benway does it again. Religious freedom in the animal kingdom. This one, now, for all my students out there. Oh, sorry, I just thinking about, just thinking sometimes. It's about this girl. She really likes yellow hats. She deceives her Spanish teacher. No, she... she had a test in her Spanish class, and she misspelled the Spanish word for love. And she deceives her Spanish teacher. I just think she spelled it right. Really? these sisters have a really good icing recipe and they are not allowed. Storm has a face, and the plot twist at the end is it also has a head. So, you know how you... all of us know some people, and this book... so, she knows... Someone's phone breaks, and this is the only message they get on there. Restore me. Restore me. And she can't restore her phone's memory. She lost all of her selfies.
This book that I'm reading has a really cool design feature. At the bottom of each right-hand side page is this little cow that just keeps moving across until finally it just sort of tumbles off the edge. I got this as an advanced reader copy at a library conference several years ago, and I really don't know much about it other than it's about pranks. My guess is there's some cow tipping involved. I'm really excited to actually start reading it and find out more. It's called Don't Get Caught by Kurt Denon.
I got a dream, I got some dreams. Somebody get me a glass, because I just found me a tall drink of water.
Of 1,000,000. Sexy, sweet, yummy.
I don't know why I ever leave this place. I've got all the company I need right here.
Love can't differentiate between what is real and fake. So women use paper and pen. Juliet, she took the bait. Orpheus was far too late. So now I love fictional men.
It's so dumb.
It's so dumb, it's brilliant.
No! It's just dumb!
I always think it's so funny when people say things like, books are great, but you should really try to have those experiences in real life. I don't think I'm ever gonna experience riding a dragon unless you know something I don't. What are you hiding, Susan?
What did you do? What?
Suck dick on accident.
How the fuck do you suck dick on...
Shut up, it is not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Someone asked if I had read this book. And I have. I read it today.
How's your morning going? About to have a mental breakdown, how about you? Nice, nice. I'm in the middle of a mental breakdown already.
So we get it.
You don't get it.
Come on, Lisa.
You don't get it.